Hello everyone. It's nice to see you all here again. Today I'm Alina Daskanova and I'm WorldSkills Russia Deputy Director General and I'm Technical Delegate at WorldSkills International. You are really welcome to our WorldSkills Russia National Competition and this special sessions which we are holding every day to share our experience. More than 40 countries registered to take part in our sessions. One key important point that please mute your mic if you are not speaking. Also important information that we have streamed to our YouTube channel as well. If you have time difference, so you don't have time for particular day, you can later come back and watch the video. The program have already been sent to your email and the program is following that we already have experience to show you our competition management centers and we have showed you our venues. Also yesterday with our experts we discussed how it's possible to make assessment online and today the day is discuss with our partners how our companies and business support our online events, not just competition, but education system as well. As all of us now at this pandemic situation, challenge with a new reality when we have to arrange a lot of online activities and our partners will share with you the experience. Also, next days, it will be skills overview and live broad screen from competition size. So the program for today is following that we have here with us our colleague from WorldSkills Russia department who is responsible for cooperation with partners. And we have our companies who are leading and leaders in the world skills development and skills development, not just in Russia, but also across the world and globally. So now we'd like to give the word to Semyon. Semyon, could you please share information how WorldSkills Russia now working with our partners?
Yes, sure. Hello, everyone. Good to see you. I hope you can see me well and you can hear me well. I will give you the brief update how we work with our partners in the current situation with the pandemic and how we switched our offline activities into online. It was a challenging process because we were limited in time and we had to change everything that we did before and all the rights and benefits that we give to our partners into online. Because traditionally we provide them some things that they could physically receive and physically use, such as exhibition booth. We placed their logos on fences, on the stelas, so where was the skill description. We also placed all their logos on the surfaces around the venue, on the venue and outside the venue. But in current situation, we had to refuse from these options because we didn't have the physical things and we moved basically to online. The most significant changes that we did is the online broadcasting and all the benefits that we were ready to give to our partners, they were related to this broadcast. So the first one, we did some kind of thank you video for all the partners who supported our competition. So this video included all the logos of our partners with the all the statuses that they had and they could see their logos during our opening and closing ceremonies. Another thing that we did is that we had the live interviews with all the partners. So when we speak about any skill that we have. We have the live interview with the partner who supported this skill, where the representative of our companies, they told us about the skill, what they did, how do they support this skill, for how long they are with us, what benefits do they have from supporting WorldSkills Russia and from this particular skill. Another thing we did is Zoom interviews with partners. So during our broadcasting, we have live interviews with main partners that we have, where they can also share their experience and discuss something with our colleagues, with experts. And they also have the opportunity to promote their companies during these interviews. Next thing, very big thing that we did is the promo videos of some partners who would like to share it with us. It's something like an advertising campaign, a small advertising post during the broadcast where they shared their videos with people who actually watched this broadcasting. And another very big and very significant thing that we did is the mobile app and the website with all the logos of our partners divided into different levels. And when you click on the logo of any partner, you can easily get an access to their pages, to the information about these companies, to their websites, to the contact information of any company. So it also makes easily for partners to promote their products. We also have some things that we couldn't realize during this national competition, but we still have time just to write them down and realize it in during our next skills competition. This is it from my side. Thank you, Alina.
Thank you, Semyon. So as all you can see, this situation which we have here, we even developed special applications. And through these applications, we can get access to much huge and broad auditory with much more customers, as well as our educational system and our real sectors of economy, and provide more information about WorldSkills in general and about competition for the more people. So the next speaker, Peter, are you here with us?
Yes, I'm here, hello.
Oh, nice to see you again. Peter is one of our management center. So Peter, could you share, please?
So, dear colleagues, I'm glad to see you in this not standard situation for me. As usually, I talk with some people, some professionals, face to face. It's great, but today, did you see my screen?
Пока нет.
Sorry. I'm so sorry. So, okay, and try again. Now I see it. So for me, it's and for all of us, I think it was a very strange year with situation of COVID, and for all of us, it was a little challenge. A challenge of to try to find out a new system, a new situation, then we work with our educational system in our professional competitions. I'm not only the expert of all skills. First, I'm a representative of one of the companies who is a partner of all skills. Of WorldSkills Russia in 7 years for us. We start our partnership with WorldSkills in 1913, then our competition is an electrical installation, start in Russia, in WorldSkills Russia. It was in Siberia region, it was a long leadership. And why our company came to World Skills? Because for us, it's not a business. It's a passion, as some of my friend from Expert Society, International Expert Society, told about it. Passion, why? Because we need to have a great, good specialists in our profession, in electrical installation. In Russia, we have a situation then our electricians know nothing about equipment. Know nothing about new equipment, old equipment, and work in a way of 70s years, of 1970s, I suppose. And in 2013, we start to work with old skills. At first we started partner. Afterward, we start to support the national team. We ask our specialists from our educational department to work with World Skills experts and try to improve our marketing system in electric installation. And alone, cases they have. Now, in this competition, they have a status as a platinum partner of competition. About this online competition, they have in 2020. Why? At first, and what we do for this? At first, we take a part in writing a test project. It's development, it's testing. Because we are the, one of the main electrical engineering company in Russia. They make some our meetings, online meetings, to make a dialogue with expert society. We call it the days of IK group. And we try to make a situation then in the online regime. It was a conversation between product managers of our company and certified experts of World Skills Russia. Certified experts, what does it mean? It's a main expert. In Russia, it's about 60 people who improve our competition in some Russian regions. This is a great professionals who know a lot of about electrical installation. After that, they make a series of technical web runs, webinars. They make a technical support of the competition. We try to give some answers to the technical questions of our regions. In our competition, in the basic age, looks like in World Skills from 16 and from 16 to 21, it is 30 regions. In our junior competition, they have 15 regions. And all of the regions have a lot of questions about equipment and how to work with it. And they supplied some equipment to three regions in which we have the places of, the centers of, centers leading of competition. So the centers are in Russia, in Moscow, in Kazan, and in Novokuznetsk. The situation with 2019 was a big challenge at first for traditional skill jobs, like an electric installation, like industrial control, and overall competition, traditional competition. Why? Because our competition is not a digital competition. For us, it needs to be in connection, in communication with some people, to make some things in other places. We can't sit at home and do our work. So for us, it was a big challenge and how we try to work with it. At first, we based our work in one of the principles from the Kazan Declaration. It principle was future skills for everyone. What does it mean for us? Our competition is not a future skill, but electrical installation have some parts which we can called like a future skills. For suppose in electrical installation is only 10 euros, if I remember true, they have a programming of our installations. Before, these installations are not programming with special equipment like PLCs and other things. It was only then install some montage, wire some equipment and other things. But programming for us, it was a future skills. And we will take and we took digital technologies from our competition. After that, we start a distant learning. For us, it was a request from one of the technical school of Russia. They need to make a practice in electrical installation, but they can't do it because it was a situation when these students can go to college and can't make something by their hands, because in their home they can't make cabinets, they can't give a big installations, only open their circuits on their walls. And they organize for them a distant learning. Distance learning of the knowledge they can't take in the colleges. And the third thing they make, master classes. As usual, it's a video classes to make a situation where we can change our knowledges between, exchange our knowledges between some people. We go to a digital. For us, online competition was a little shock. At first, the online competition, now national competition. And we have some risks in this competition, and we have some profits in this competition. As risks, we can talk about unconventional format of this competition, because then you look at the screen near me, I have some screens, and I can see all regions, how our specialists, juniors, and the basic age work in the cabinets, but I can't make a mark of the work really like an electrician. I can only look at some pictures, look at some video, but I can't make it real in our tradition. First, we have new conditions. We need to make, we need to set up a big video studio with a lot of workstation, a lot of cameras. We can have some problems with internet because it's a lot of videos. Our experts can make some mistakes and other risks you can see in the screen. About benefits, first benefits and the main benefit, I think, it's a benefit then they can collect a lot of experts from a lot of countries. For suppose, if we talk about juniors, in our junior competition, they have not only Russia, they have at least three more countries. In our standard age competition, they have at least two countries. And it has a lot of regions they can't make, they can build in a traditional, in offline, they a 40 or 50 cabinets. But now we can work with about 60 teams. And about, you know, things, they make an online career advice. At first, they work with kids, they take a part in our project, our Russian project, which leads by Ursus Russia, is a ticket to the future. I think you hear about heard about it. So then they work with these programs. They change program and they flash out installation, and they improve our programming. It's I told about it. It's a digitalization of our competition. They tested in some Russian's children's centers. For suppose Arlena, Bosmena, it's a camps, it's old camps. They have at least 60 or 70 years old. And in these camps, as usually, we work with kids. Before it was kids and teach them by something about competition. And now we work with them, and give them some education for this competition online. What we had so when we worked with kids. Last year, we make our online career advice, our corporate career advice for children, for juniors. We call it Future Challenge, and we have a lot of offline meetings with them. We teach them basic skills. They can use an equipment. We make for them group master classes. They ask for our champions from World Skills Junior for World Skills Junior International Competition for Juniors. We was where we try to teach our groups of our juniors, and it was very interesting for them. And they make a demonstration exam by World Skills standards. For us, it was normal because it was offline. And how we change it now, when we are in the online regime. We try to make an online day of our lessons. We try to tell our juniors, tell to our kids how to make real schematics in an online regime, use the use some platform for online meetings, and after that they show them the program for the base. We took our program on EPLR system. It's a programming of these electrical schemes. And we think that this is a good way to show kids our competition and to make some impact for kids start interested by our competition. And I think it's better than our in offline regime. Why? Because a lot of kids, they use some laptops, we use some phones, smartphones, and they have a habit to talk with digital skills. And we find out the digital skills and give it to our kids. So it's a little bit about our experience in the COVID system. Colleagues, if you have some questions, I ready to answer you.
Thank you, Peter. The cooperation with EEC is very important for us, especially like you support all scale of competitions from junior competition to adults. And thank you for sharing these cases and that you support and continue support for Skills Russia. Just to tell also that through the competition, we like usually on the venue, we have this try skill format when kids can come and try themselves with skills they're interested in. And now World Skills Russia and our colleagues run every day more than around like hundreds different kind of trial skills for our skilled children. And it's really great that we run this program with support of our partners. And the next one is Ilya Tankih. He represents DMG, and this is a global industrial partner for World Skills Movement globally. So Ilya, could you share your experience, please?
Hello, colleagues. You hear me well?
Yes.
Okay, very good. I start my presentation. Yeah, okay. So first of all, I'm glad to be here with you and to share our experience. You know, this year starts with a not very good story with the virus. But still, we need to find the solutions how to do and how to move. Because DMG MORE is a worldwide company producing CNC machines, and we are the biggest CNC academy, and we have more than 20 1,000 customers a year, each year. We have to find out the solution how to support our customers and industry customers and also educational customers, how to use new technologies, how to show that we, everybody talks about digitization and industry 4.0, and this is a good time to present what we can do and to show that, that we are sitting at homes or colleges are alone, only with the teachers, without students, and how we can share, and also how we can continue our stories with the championships, with the competitions, but in the new way. So first of all, I want to present you the what we are doing now, the, our, how to say, results already. We make some nice, not the test, but some internal competitions. And first of all, we already try to do online CNC competition. Of course, we use the WorldSkills International standards, like a basic, like a standard, but at the same time, we have to find a solution how we continue to follow the fairness of the competition and do that all our competitors can do their parts, and we judge them and measure the parts correctly for everybody. And we create this one solution. I do some highlights about this. So the same standards as we have. We use the same infrastructure list for different sites. So competitor have used the machine on each competitor on each site. We use cameras that shows, one camera shows the basic working area and the second camera shows more detailed what he's currently working on the machines on CNC. We invite industry experts who is independently standing in front of the competitor, but with a safety distance, and don't move to the machine if everything is going right. So at the same time, we are safely working with the machines and with the test project. And at the same time, the expert is here and everything is running like on the normal WorldSkills competition. To judge all the parts, it's very interesting. We make one, we choose one center, and we send from different cities of Russia these parts into this center. These parts are specially packed, not to be damaged during the transportation. And then after this, we, with a special team, also in front of the cameras, measure the parts, judge the parts. So we will do everything the same that we will be done on the normal championship, but we will do it on the different sites. And yeah, this runs well. We make some special rules in the technical descriptions. So in this case, all experts were satisfied, no competitors satisfied, and we have near the same results as the WorldSkills. I mean, I use words near. It means not near with the quality, but of course we unfortunately lose the feeling when we sit all together, discussion the development, discussion the share our experience. But in the other way around, we have possibilities to sit here in front of the computers and share our experience online. So the second, what we are doing, especially with the preparation of the students for the, not only for the world skill, but also for the industry work, for the factories, we start online training. These possibilities we start not only in Russia, but also like at MG Warrior Academy worldwide for the different customers. Of course, it's not the same as a normal training when you stand in front of the teacher in front of the machine, but still our work, and we see also some benefits or some highlights that I want to share with you. So still we have a good programming experience, because when you're programming usually in the classroom, here you have the same computers in the network, the different person sit in front of their computer and the teacher can share the screen and see what he's doing. So the same logic we have near the same. We have to do it, we have to share our training documents, we make it digital before we give the normal books where they can write with a pen. So, and this also works nice. The communication with the trainer comes the same logic as in the LEAF training. And one benefit we have is there is no problem with the travel time and no cost for this, no limited hotel, because we can spend more time and a little bit save money to make trainings together. The same we do with the teachers. And on the screen, I show you, you see the pictures, how we do programming before and how we make online training programming. And the same with the practice, we use in the training center several cameras, and we show in front of the camera, our trainer stand in front of the machine and show which buttons and how he uses the machine. And then, of course, the person try to do it. Of course, it's working well when you have the same machine, the same working tools, and you can share with this experience, but of course, it's not fully 100% can cover the real training. But still, we find the solution how to work. It's very important that globally this virus time, we have to think what to do next globally for the digitalization of the education processes, of the digitalization of the industry. And we make some research, and what we see, still a lot of employees in the factories are often behind in our fast change world. Their workshop requirements, information and evaluation, a lot of papers still in the factories, and a lot of IT resources need to run this, and this is, takes time, and your employees need to know how to do it, especially the teachers who prepare the new students for this new area. The second very interesting thing that we learn, it's I call it challenge in the industry, where we check that still approximately 70% of factory problems, of industry problems, are based on the deficits in information and knowledge. So still some information is missing, some working process or some type of digital solution support you to solve these problems. And what we find out, we find it's just, for example, one company, it's called one software, it's called Tulip. It's a special software. It's quite simple to use. It's like a PowerPoint in the logic of use. There is no code programming. I myself tried to do it, and it's very interesting to program. And together with the software, with some digital sensors, you can try to change your analog working process or analog training process into the digital world. And you can create your own apps. Also what we did in Academy, we create training apps, then can train operator some parts, some models without the teacher completely. So I mean, we write a program, we integrate it together with a machine, and we just give an app, and step by step, operator or student goes this step, and the machine itself teach him. And if he do not something wrong on the machine, the sensors show that he doing something wrong. In this case, he can continue until he do the first step correct. And for the basic courses, for the basic elements, it works very nice. And now we are developing together with the colleges in Russia, how to, and not only in Russia, but in the other countries, how to continue developing this software. So you see how can look the full classroom with this software, you can, where you can write these apps, what you can integrate it with the real machines. That it's very interesting that you can integrate this process not only in CNC part, but you can also integrate in the different other areas, in the all industry areas are 100% available together with a combination with this. And in this case, you can get some interesting results like an improving learning effect. You have interactive training process with the machine feedback. So that when the robot or machine or mechanism give you feedback, and you know how he reacts on this. But very interesting that you create with the teacher this mechanism, how it works, and then you can easily update it during the change in the world. So if something in the CNC tournament is really in the future will change in the process or will add something new, we can easily correct this app, correct this strategy, and you will get in the end the new methodics and new processes for the training of the person. So which areas, application areas, it can continue. And I show it to you because we are working with these areas. It can be visual work instructions. So it's the lowest simple automation process when you, for example, you're training, assemble the tools. You don't need machine for this. You don't need programming, but still it's very important part when you prepare in the working place, the working table, the working area, and then you can use this software to digitize this, and you don't need any more papers. You can do everything on the computer, on the telephone, whatever you, where you have internet and the screen. Then you have training itself, more automated training without the person. I want to highlight it again, because to run these basic trainings, you don't need the teacher. Probably in this time when we're sitting at home or when we're working on the special distance, the person comes to the machine and working alone, and the teacher can online correct him and give him examples and whatever he like. And also the teacher see how the machine reacts, what the sensors are working, what is wrong, what is right. Audit and quality, this is maybe more interesting for the industry, but also I have an idea also how to implement maybe these tulip solutions in the access assessment and in marking scheme in the WorldSkills International. So I will also make some tests in WorldSkills Rush, and then I give feedback so we can make some kind of digitize our measurement and judgment in the CNC learning and CNC milling. Of course, machine monitoring, order tracking, and digital learning, this is the process that we already have in the educational sector, and this will be improved. So our concept fully, when we will integrate these processes, we want to have some kind of integrated digitization in 5 steps that will be follow all our educational process, and we want to integrate this process with the colleges, and in the end, we will get complete specialists on the real industry sector who know all the processes in the, not even in the IT, or the digitization of the documents or the processes or the sensors, who can, without additional support, run the new modern machines, run new modern technologies. And if they will change during time to time, year to year, he can himself understand how to improve his knowledge. So what we are currently planning to do in Russia with some colleges, we want to make some kind of educational digital factory. It's our new project. I hope next year we will get some real result. When we, in the first row, we have machine with some sensors. This is a lot of colleges in Russia and worldwide have. The next step, we will do the smart college when we connect machines between itself, start this digitization process with a software like Tulip and some other softwares, and try to collect all of that information and integrate it in the educational process, make some removed lessons, make some other lessons, and in the finally, that this experience and these people can change the industry and start creating the smart industry and digital factories. Thank you in advance for your careful listening. If you have any questions, you can write me an email for answering. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ilya. That's really great that you share your experience with us. I would like to mention that in Russia, DMG support us also for WorldSkills High Tech competition. It's competition for workers. And like WorldSkills Russia is not just responsible for competition, but we're responsible for skills development across country and for creating new productivity models for our companies, how to increase productivity at the working place. So we are piloting new technologies in our competition, and then we implement this new technology to the education system, and then from education system to real sector of economy. So that's really great that our partners are really quite ahead of education and industry, and that they're ready to pilot together with WorldSkills Russia and together with global movement WorldSkills. So if countries are interested to pilot with us, please join us this project. And as you can see that a lot of question was how to manage with manufacturing skills and skills competition in digital format. However, as we already shared, we experienced that there is special centers who make assessments and measurements, and all competitors from all the countries send the final completed details to the centers, and measurement can be done. Okay, thank you, Leah. And now I would like to invite Елена to share with us our KNAU experience of KNAU в компании. Елена, вы с нами? Just a moment. Елена, вы нас слышите? Yes, Елена told me that she can hear us. So I hope she has managed to share the screen with us.
Hello, I'm here. Can you see me?
Yes.
Okay, good. Let me take a minute to find my presentation. Alina, unfortunately, I can't find my screen in the device.
Just a moment, I will share them from my computer. Лен, видите?
Отлично. Thank you very much. Hello, dear colleagues. As my English is not so fluent that Russian, I will take the support of professional interpreters because I have a lot to tell about our collaboration with all skills. And we have a big experience together. Next slide, please. Okay. Я представляю компанию KNAU, которая является ведущим производителем в мире строительных отделочных материалов на гипсовой основе. Компания KNAU была основана в 1932 году в Германии, и до сих пор компания растет и является, как я уже сказала, ведущим производителем гипсовых материалов и компании, которая поставляет, наверное, прежде всего качественный материал. Следующий слайд, пожалуйста.
So, Елена is representing KNAU company, and as all of us know, KNAU company is one of the leading companies in gypsum mining industry, and it was founded in 1932 in Germany, and as I've already mentioned, it's one of the biggest companies in the world.
Сейчас мы работаем практически на всех континентах мира, имеем более 255 заводов, более 35 тысяч сотрудников и годовой оборот более 10 миллиардов евро.
So basically, KNAU now is present in all the continents. It's about 137 countries. It's about 255 plants all around the world and 35 people in the staff.
Next slide, please. В России мы производим продукцию на более чем 20 заводах, имеем 6 сбытовых и 4 региональных sales directions и 80 учебных центров.
So speaking about Russia, here we have 20 manufacturing plants, 6 sales offices and 4 regional separate branches, and also 80 technology training centers.
Следующий слайд, пожалуйста. Ну и поскольку материалы КНАУФ являются высококачественными, мы заинтересованы в том, чтобы их применение было профессиональными строителями, обычными строителями.
So as KNAUF is a high quality product, we're interested in the usage of these products by some professional manufacturers.
Следующий слайд, пожалуйста. Я приготовила короткую аналитику по популярности профессий, строительных профессий в России. Как написано в левом графике, строитель-отделочник входит в пятерку самых популярных профессий.
So I've prepared just a brief analytics for you here about the popularity of the building profession in Russia. And as you can see, the decorating builder is one of the most popular professions in Russia.
На графике в центре мы можем видеть, как растет количество выпускников колледжей по данным строительным профессиям отделочников.
If you look at the second picture, you can see the number, how it increases, the number of the graduates from the college who take this as their major.
И на правом графике мы видим виды материалов, используемых для производства стен в России. И мы можем видеть, что гипсокартон является самым популярным материалом сейчас для стен и облицовок.
If you look in the picture in the right side, you can see the materials that are most widely used in Russia, and you can see that plasterboard is one of the most usable ones.
Следующий слайд, пожалуйста. Поэтому мы много учим работать именно с гипсокартоном, с каркасно-обшивными конструкциями, о том, как нужно применять эти материалы так, чтобы стены были надежными, долговечными и прочными.
So that's why we are giving a lot of trainings for working with plasterboard and also for framework covering materials so that this would be really reliable constructions.
Поэтому мы идем в коллаборацию с крупнейшими лидерами рынка, которые, собственно, работают на рынке популяризации рабочих профессий, поднятия их престижа.
So we are trying to
Следующий
have
слайд.
Partnership with all the large representatives of the industry.
Будьте добры, переключите слайд, пожалуйста. И еще один слайд, пожалуйста, сразу. Соответственно, основную работу, которую мы делаем, это обучение, легитимация профессии и популяризация рабочих профессий среди молодежи.
So the main job we are doing here, we are trying to popularize the working professions among young people.
В части обучения и популяризации профессии среди молодежи цели КНАУФ, цели Академии КНАУФ и цели WorldSkills совпадают. Соответственно, на данном слайде вы можете видеть хронологию развития сотрудничества между компанией КНАУФ и WorldSkills. Верните прежний слайд. Спасибо.
So, speaking about the popularization of professions and also giving trainings, the aims of KNAUF and WorldSkills, they are just the same. And here in this slide, you can see the history of cooperation of KNAUF and WorldSkills.
Наше сотрудничество началось в 2012 году. Это год основания WorldSkills в России. Наше сотрудничество продолжается по сей день. Мы очень рады, что наша коллаборация привела к достойной победе нашего участника в чемпионате мира в прошлом году в Казани.
So KNAUF and WorldSkills started their cooperation in 2012. It was the year of the WorldSkills Russia movement here. And we are really happy that through the years, through many years of hard work, it all lead to the win of our competitor at the skill.
Эта победа нашего участника Имрана Тачиева доказала, что Россия сейчас номер один в сухом строительстве в мире. И мы очень рады, что совместно с WorldSkills мы смогли добиться этого большого достижения.
So this medal we achieved last year of our competitor, it proved that now Russia is number one in drywall and plastering systems, and we are really happy that together with WorldSkills we were able to achieve such results.
Следующий слайд, пожалуйста. Весь этот путь мы прошли в активностях. Это и разработка заданий, и совместное обучение педагогов, и оборудование площадок, и предоставление материалов, организация среди детей, скиллс, и так далее. Все годы мы были вместе в WorldSkills и КНАУФ с одной целью – популяризация профессии, развитие моды на сухое строительство среди молодежи.
So through many years we had a lot of different activities and projects together with WorldSkills, and we were happy to have trainings for teachers and for competitors, and also different workshops. And all this cooperation was following one general aim. It was to popularize the profession and in Russia.
Следующий слайд. И если мы говорим о коллаборации КНАУФ и WorldSkills, мы не останавливаемся только на России. Поскольку Академия КНАУФ, группы КНАУФ ИСТ работает и осуществляет производственную и сбытовую деятельность в странах СНГ, Академия КНАУФ также сотрудничает с системой образования с властями в странах СНГ.
So when we speak about the cooperation of KNAUF and WorldSkills, we are not speaking only about the Russian Federation. As you know, KNAUF has manufacturing activities and also in CIS countries. That is why we also have some cooperation with CIS countries.
Поэтому все лучшие практики, весь наш опыт взаимодействия КНАУФ и WorldSkills в России мы переносим на страны СНГ, такие как у нас уже есть результаты, и мы поддерживаем чемпионаты в Казахстане, в Белоруссии, в Узбекистане.
So speaking about our experience, we mean experience that we have with WorldSkills, we are trying to apply this very experience to the other countries of the CIS. These are Kazakhstan, Belarus, Ukraine, for example, where we run the competitions.
Uzbekistan, not Ukraine. Окей. Хотелось бы отметить, что на этом пути мы, конечно же, не обходимся без диджитал-технологий. На самом деле благодаря Digital мы можем обучать студентов, мы можем обучать экспертов, мы можем оттачивать навыки монтажа технологий сухого строительства посредством Digital программ и специальных девайсов.
So also we would like to mention that we are using digital technologies in this process. Through these digital technologies, we are trying to give trainings to experts and competitors also, and to prove their skills, and also to give some information about drywall and plastering.
Нам в помощь пришли те продукты, которые были созданы Академией КНАУФ за последние 5 лет. Это электронный учебник по сухому строительству, содержащий более 18 лабораторно-практических модулей, в рамках которых ребята онлайн могут монтировать перегородки, возводить облицовки, пробовать монтировать потолки и так далее.
So speaking about these very digital resources, we should mention, first of all, the electronic textbook, which includes 18 practical modules that give an opportunity for the competitors to practice the installation of different walls, floors, etc.
Сейчас, когда пандемия пришла во все страны, мы особенно понимаем ценность этого ресурса обучения. Мы видим, насколько много и серьезно стали обращаться к диджитал-ресурсам в обучении. Поэтому мы также используем специальные электронные модули для обучения студентов университета, вебинары для преподавателей, экспертов и участников чемпионатов.
Now, when we have this pandemic situation in the world, we especially appreciate these very digital resources that we can use for giving trainings and also giving different trainings for experts and use them in our learning process.
Следующий слайд, пожалуйста. Хотелось бы отметить также популярность специальных обучающих видео у молодого поколения, у участников чемпионата, потому что такое клиповое мышление, запоминание по картинке сейчас приоритетно. Соответственно, мы производим специальные обучающие фильмы по монтажу систем строительства, которые находит компетенции 1 Plastering Drywall Systems.
So I would also like to mention that educational films are really popular among young people because now we are much more oriented to the picture thinking and cognition, we mean information cognition. And that is why we are trying to produce more and more educational films for them.
Также мы создаем специальные посадочные страницы на базе сайтов колледжей и техникумов, которые позволяют в большей степени пропагандировать и популяризировать рабочие профессии монтажника систем сухого строительства.
So we are also trying to create some landing pages inside the website of different vocational schools and colleges so that we can again popularize the profession.
Ну и, конечно же, мы идем в ногу с большими технологиями визуализации, соединения визуализации и практики, и разрабатываем VR-симуляторы, VR-тренажеры для монтажа систем сухого строительства, перегородок различного типа, в различных типах условий и при использовании различных материалов.
So we are also trying to use modern technologies in our processes, and we are also referring to the connection of visualization and practice, and we are trying to develop VR simulators for creating the drywall systems and using different conditions, different materials, and to look how they work in real life.
Сейчас в заданиях WallSkills Очень часто не знают, какие будут материалы, какие будут конструкции. Поэтому очень важно, что студенты могут в VR-тренажерах, VR-симуляторах пробовать как раз-таки разные материалы, разные конструкции и, собственно, ориентировать самих себя по времени, смотреть на свои ошибки и фиксировать свои результаты.
So if we speak about the current situation, it's very common that in the test project, the competitors do not know which materials they are going to use. That's why VR simulators are really useful in this situation because they can try to use different materials and to understand the time they need for them and their mistakes they are making.
Следующий слайд, пожалуйста. Спасибо за возможность выступить. Большое спасибо за внимание. С большим удовольствием послушать своих коллег по цеху.
So thank you for very much for your attention, and that is all for today. And I would be glad to hear to my colleagues.
Елена, thank you very much. The partnership with Knauf is really important for WorldSkills Russia and for development of WorldSkills movement across CIS countries. We hope that if any other countries are interested, they can connect you as well. The key important point that we are making really is this training videos together with our partners. And this like training videos, even some videos made with our competitors who achieve the gold results. So they, and with our experts who explain how to manage these trainings. And also that's really great that Knauf not just support WorldSkills movement, but our education system. And from our best practice which we develop during competitions, we can spread this practice across Knauf centers. And that's really great that by WorldSkills Russia we have a conception to develop key important centers across the country, and Knauf support us with this development. So now when we got this pandemic situation, we already have really great infrastructure which can be used for competition and spread format. And it's really great that Knauf developing this VR technology for better training and better performance of our students, workers, and competitors. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Alina. Thank you very much for this opportunity. Thank you.
And I would like to invite Maria Pravdina. She represents 1C company. Our 1C company have global partner for Kazan 2019 and our partner in development IT sector. Maria, nice to see you.
Hello everyone. I'm glad to see our great WorldSkills family here. Can you see my presentation?
Yeah.
Thank you. Я прошу подключиться переводчика. И сначала хочу сказать, что очень горжусь теми достижениями, теми проектами, которые сделали мои коллеги. И мы действительно достаточно хорошо подготовились к переходу мира в новый онлайн-формат.
So I'm really proud of all the achievements and the results of the projects that my colleagues did, and we're really, really ready for the transition to the new format.
Для информационных технологий это, может быть, было не так сложно. Мы привыкли работать дистанционно. Но, тем не менее, некоторые новые решения я вам тоже продемонстрирую.
For IT sphere, it was not that difficult because we are used to working in such a situation, but maybe I will show you some new solutions here.
Но IT-бизнес переходит в такую удаленную работу, и вот я, в общем, теперь работаю из домашнего офиса, как и все мои коллеги.
So IT-бизнес is becoming a remote one, so as all my colleagues do, I'm also working from home now.
Чтобы было понятно, что из себя представляет задача по переходу в дистанционный формат, я немного поясню ситуацию в IT-сфере России.
I would like to speak a little bit about the IT situation in Russia so that you would understand what it means for us to go to a distant format.
Россия большая страна с населением почти 150 миллионов человек, в которой очень активно развивается IT-сектор и в публичном сегменте, и в сегменте бизнес-автоматизации, и гражданских сервисов.
So the Russian Federation is a huge country. We have the population of almost 150 million people, and we have a really high speed of development of the IT sector, both in public sector, business automation and services.
Около 2 миллионов человек заняты в информационных и коммуникационных технологиях, но для такой страны, как Россия, это все-таки еще достаточно мало.
So now about 2 million people are involved in information and communication technologies sector, but for such a big country as Russia, it's not enough for now.
Ежегодно нам нужно новых, больше 200 тысяч новых программистов, новых разработчиков.
So annually we need more than 200,000 new IT specialists and developers.
И это огромная задача для нашей компании, 1C Company.
So for our company, 1C Company, it's just a big task to do.
1C Company занимается автоматизацией бизнес-процессов, и эти решения используются практически во всех российских компаниях.
So speaking about 1C Company, we are trying to automate the business processes, and it's used for all the companies. IT companies.
Больше 5 миллионов человек ежедневно работают с решениями 1С.
So more than 5 million people are using 1C solutions.
И больше 300 тысяч разработчиков, программистов бизнес-приложений разрабатывают решения на платформе 1C Enterprise.
So about 300,000 people, developers, use 1C Enterprise for developing their framework.
Кроме этого, решения 1C Enterprise применяются более чем в 100 странах мира, а в 30 странах у нас есть очные учебные центры.
So besides that, 1C Enterprise solutions are used in more than 100 countries, and we can also organize trainings in more than 30 countries.
Модель WorldSkills, ну, в частности, WorldSkills Россия, дала нам инструмент, как от подготовки лучших чемпионов переходить к массовому обучению.
So the model of the WorldSkills Russia gave us a tool to make not only the champions of the competition, but also to give mass training.
WorldSkills дал нам хорошие стандарты, по которым нужно, на которые нужно ориентироваться.
WorldSkills Russia gave us high standards that we are going to use.
Экспертное сообщество, которое разрабатывает и развивает и продвигает эти стандарты.
And also it gave us expert community who is developing and promoting these standards.
И очень быстрый цикл обновления учебных программ воспитания нового уровня специалистов.
And a cycle of rapid innovations in the upbringing of new specialists of the sphere.
Поэтому с 2017 года 1C Company является партнером WorldSkills Россия во всех проектах.
So that is why starting from 2017, 1C Company became a partner of the WorldSkills Russia in all the projects.
И все направления работы, ну, мы, собственно, легко смогли перенести и в онлайн-формат.
That is why all the directions of our work, we were able to put them into a distant format.
Начиная с предоставления программного обеспечения до обучения преподавателей.
Starting with providing software and also giving trainings to the teachers.
Практики для студентов, дополнительные тренировки, приглашение бизнес-партнеров к сотрудничеству, к подготовке специалистов.
So giving practice training for the competitors, also some preparation for specialists.
участие в разработке test project и все другие направления.
And also participation in the development of the test project and other different directions of work.
Но с изменением ситуации мы получили еще и некоторые новые возможности, причем очень интересные.
So with the new situation, we also gained some new possibilities of work, and some of them were really interesting ones.
В весной этого года мы спланировали проведение скиллс-кэмпа на Филиппинах. И планировали, что наши специалисты прилетят на Филиппины, организуют учебную программу, проведем чемпионат на Филиппинах, но это не получилось.
So in spring, this year spring, we were planning to have a skills camp in the Philippines, and we were planning to send our specialists to that country to have the competition, but we didn't manage to do that.
Нам пришлось очень быстро поменять формат и перевести весь этот skills camp в онлайн-режим.
So we had to change the format and to make it a distant one.
Но это дало нам новые возможности. К этой программе на Филиппинах смогли присоединиться ребята из Марокко, ребята из России, ребята из Вьетнама.
But it gave us new possibilities, because this way some participants from Morocco, from Russia were able to take part in the competition also.
И сейчас завершается в рамках этого skills camp завершается разработка мобильных приложений для социальных служб Филиппин.
So in the framework of the skills camp in the Philippines, now we are finishing the development of mobile apps for the social services of the Philippines.
Лучшие команды уже находятся на такой финишной прямой.
So the best team is finishing their project.
Но параллельно с этим случилось, ну, один из участников из Марокко уже был приглашен к реализации наших проектов фирмы 1С в ЮАР.
So, but at the same time, one of the participants that was a guy from Morocco, he was invited to for creation of the project of 1C in, извините, не услышала.
ЮАР, Южная Африка.
In South Africa.
South Africa, yeah. В общем, таким образом у нас произошло такое расширение возможностей, которые мы даже и не предполагали.
So we had a new wide variety of opportunities that we didn't really expect.
Точно так же онлайн мы смогли поучаствовать и провести онлайн-тренинг для представителей WorldSkills Asia.
So we also had a possibility to conduct an online distance training for the representatives of WorldSkills Asia.
Мы в поддержку планируемого чемпионата WorldSkills Asia, а мы подготовили инфраструктуру для проведения чемпионата.
So to give support to the competition that WorldSkills Asia is planning to conduct, we've prepared all the infrastructure for that competition.
Мы очень надеемся, что WorldSkills Asia примет наше предложение по поддержке инфраструктуры.
So we really hope that WorldSkills Asia is going to accept our proposal on the infrastructure support.
И мы также предлагаем применить эту инфраструктуру на мероприятиях в разных странах и в разных региональных чемпионатах.
And we also propose to use this infrastructure for different competitions in all the other countries.
Если вам это интересно, вы напишите мне, свяжитесь со мной, и мы можем обсудить проведение такого дистанционного чемпионата.
If you are interested in this information, you can text me and I will tell you all the details about such a format of the competition.
Вообще, онлайн-ресурсы для изучения приложений и программирования мы используем достаточно давно. Это традиционный формат для IT.
So, for a long time, we have already been using different online formats for programming and developing different applications. So this format is really common for us.
Эти ресурсы тоже стали еще более востребованы в условиях пандемии и ограничения передвижений.
So these online resources are much more needed now in the pandemic situation when we cannot leave our home.
Хочу обратить внимание на проекты по подготовке преподавателей.
And I would also would like to pay your attention to the project of professional preparation for teachers.
По компетенции IT Software Solutions for Business мы уже несколько лет совместно с Академией WorldSkills реализуем программу повышения квалификации преподавателей.
So together with the WorldSkills Academy in the framework of the IT Software Business Solutions Skill, we are organizing the training for all the teachers.
И в этом году мы ее впервые провели дистанционно, и, на мой взгляд, получается, ну, есть хорошие результаты, и программа не уступает той, которая ранее выполнялась офлайн.
So this year it was in an online format for the first time, and as we think, it's just the same as it was in an offline format, all the same qualities, everything.
Мы рассчитываем, что с сокращением вот этих ограничений на перемещение мы очень большую часть наработок вот этих образовательных мы их сохраним на будущее и продолжим использовать.
So we suppose that when the pandemic situation finishes and we have the reduction of all the measures to stay at home, etc., we just save all this work and we're going to use it for the future.
Учебные программы для обучения взрослых также переведены в онлайн-формат, и ни одна программа не была сокращена.
So if we speak about the educational programs for adult education, they are also transferred to the online format and they were not reduced.
Мы с большим удовольствием поддерживаем все проекты WorldSkills Россия и WorldSkills International и WorldSkills Азия и локальных организаций WorldSkills.
We are glad to support all the WorldSkills Russia projects and also WorldSkills International projects and some minor local projects of the WorldSkills movement.
Мы приглашаем к сотрудничеству и готовы персонально обсудить возможности и форматы партнерства в области разработки, подготовки специалистов по разработке IT-решений для бизнеса.
So we propose partnership in the development and also giving trainings to all the professionals in the sphere of the IT solutions for business.
Поэтому я приглашаю к дискуссии, к обсуждению, к общению. И в любой момент я и мои коллеги с удовольствием обсудим всевозможные направления сотрудничества.
So I invite all of you to the discussion, and if you have any questions, you can text Maria or all her colleagues to discuss the future partnership.
Спасибо большое. Thank you very much.
So thank you very much for your attention.
Maria, thank you very much. Thank you that you cooperate with the WorldSkills movement and help us to develop it further. Of course, IT sector is one of the growing sector now, and it's not just for IT sector. The skills which we provide in IT software solution for business are quite transparent and they can be applied for different skills in different sectors. So yeah. It's really great the opportunity to get the skills. And also we have to understand that nowadays, not just our educational system is changing, that our models of employment also is changing, mm-hmm. and it will be new models of cooperation between the countries. So I think that such kind of support of our partners is very important for us. And now I would like to invite Oleg from COEX. Like, I think that all our partner countries know that Russia developed future skills sector. That is very important for us to develop not just the jobs and skills which for the jobs which are most popular now in the market, but emergency jobs as well. So drone operating is one of the skill. And we have here our partner who developed the skills from the beginning and actually launched the skill in Russia and now develop this skill across the countries. Oleg, can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you clear. And do you hear me as well?
Yes.
Yeah, great. Thank you, Alina, very much. And hello to everyone. So my name is Oleg Filenek and I'm CEO and founder of Coex company. The Coex, it's a developer of open source drones for educational and industrial purposes. And also we have developed a drone operating skill competition at 2016. And in 2019, we have presented it in International Skills Competition in Kazan. So now we continue to work with 16 countries for develop this skill competitions in those countries as well. So let me share my screen. Okay. Yeah, do you see my presentation?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, thank you. So go ahead. I have told already we have worked with already 16 countries and we have more than 500 active members in our community, in our network, in Telegram groups, who people and participants who took participant in our different activities, events, competitions, and as well. Our educational model is we as an industry partner of WorldSkills Russia and a company who work with drones, who develop drones, we share our experience, our standards to WorldSkills and using instruments that provide WorldSkills to affect it to educational organizations such as schools, universities, and colleges. This is some video about how it is our competitions, how it was in Kazan. I hope you can see it. So we have already 4 years experience to organizing different events, different competitions. And this video from Kazan, 2019. You can see workshop area, you can see drones, you can see participants who are doing some test projects. And of course, you can see a lot of spectaculars who are looking how it is. It's actually very funny and attractive. They like to watch it. Also organize skill camps. We have two skill camps in July and August with different countries who was involved. What about our competition? So now we do everything in remote format using remote workshop participants connect to them via internet using some internet connections. They connect to our drones directly. They upload their code to our drones to perform a project task. They can see the view from cameras and so on. So they also use a simulator so they can do everything remotely. And you can see it here in this video. So it's not a big, it's a compact area for drones to fly in, 4x4 meters, and you can see a drone who performing autonomous task, autonomous mission that was uploaded by remote competitors on it. And no any competitors on this area, just technical experts and nothing else. Yeah, you can see these guys on the tables. So it's just the technical experts. Yeah, what participants do? So they upload autonomous missions for drones who perform some activities like flips, like recognizing some images, colors, QR codes, manipulation with some cargos and so on. We also using a simulator. It's a Gazebo simulator. It's very popular with ROS. It's robot operation systems. Combined with simulator and real workshop, we can organize in different levels of tasks for beginners and for advanced users as well. Right now at World's International Final of WorldSkills Russia, we have 37 competitors from different ages. You can see in this slide. Also, we have 5 international teams from Ecuador, Ghana, United Arab Emirates, Kazakhstan, and Malaysia. On this slide, you can see our test projects. We have different models for different ages. Main category, it's the most advanced users. They perform 4 models. For juniors, different ages, they perform 3 models and 2 models for international participants. All these participants took participant remotely. A few words about tasks is monitoring using drone, using a thermal camera and visual camera. It's diagnostic and repair some maintenance, something that was broken in drone, and so on. It's also piloting, visual piloting using flight simulator. You can see on this video an example how it is. Just some participants piloting drones using a simulator. Before pandemic was started, we're doing it in real world. We organized flight trays for drones, and they do it in real trays, but now we use simulator, and actually it works good as well. For autonomous flight, they using camera for recognize some images, objects, QR codes, and so on. Here you can see the workshop, and on this video you can see what participators see while they performing test projects. This autonomous coding model, so they can see a video from cameras on workshop. They can see shows camera on drones on drone, and they also code drones directly using a VPN connection. Okay, so it was what we do, and we would like to communicate with other countries and other industrial partners, experts, and so on. Everyone who is interested in our drone operating skill competition, we have a lot of experience, and we are glad to share our experience with you. It works for different years results of students. And we use our hardware that we manufacture. It's a Coax Clover drone kit. And the main feature of this kit set is it uses the same components as we use on the big drone. So everyone who educate using our drone kit can build also big drones as well. So it's very close to real industrial drones and real industrial tasks. And also we organize not only competitions, but also a project contests where students can participate with any kind of open source projects, with some their own projects that realize their own ideas. You can see on this slide some of the projects that was on our last year contest, Copter Hack. We use simulators. Yeah, and also we partner of other competitions and contests in the world, like MBZIRC, IMF, Innopolis Open, and Copter Hack. And we built ecosystem with different contests for students of different ages that they can participate in. So there are different levels of these competitions, and everyone can find the right competition or contest for their level and their project. Thank you very much for listening, and I will glad to answer your questions. Thank you.
Alex, thank you very much. I think that what is Alex mentioned, that they not just develop the kit and drones for real sector, they also develop kit for education system, and not just the kit itself, but this whole cycle of training. And as you can see, there is an online platform for training as well. We've been experienced to run this summer future skills camps, and quite a lot of countries join us just training camps, and we already identify that it's possible to make trainings, and not just trainings, but develop new skills and even new technologies. So this is a really great case. And as well as this is a really great case because it's new skills which have been developed for our skills movement. So thank you, Oleg, for your presentation. And I would like
Oleg, to- thank you very much. Yes, it's very important, editing.
And I would like to invite Sergey from Kempi.
Hello, Alina. Меня слышно?
Да, все хорошо.
Отлично. Мне тоже понадобится переводчик. Спасибо. I'm glad to see you all. My name is Sergey Drofeyev. I am project manager company Kempi Russia and education project. И прошу мою презентацию. Я выведу ее сам тогда на экран. Анжелика, прошу вас перевод. Мы компания, которая является партнером в компетенции сварочной технологии.
So Kempi is a company which is a partner in the welding skill.
И мы также, как и все мои коллеги, которые выступали ранее, столкнулись с теми же самыми проблемами взаимодействия с образовательными организациями в условиях пандемии.
And so, as well as all my colleagues mentioned, we had to face the same situation with the pandemic in the world.
И если мы как компания имели опыт взаимодействия в веб-формате и проведения каких-то мероприятий, то вопрос, как работать в таких условиях образовательным организациям, для нас стал приоритетным.
So as a company, we had some kind of experience working in a distant format, but speaking about educational institutions, we face some challenges in organizing our work.
Первая задача, с которой мы столкнулись, каким образом можно организовать образование и обучение в дистанционном формате именно по сварочным технологиям.
So the first task for us was the question, how can we organize the educational process in welding in an online format?
В компании Кемпи уже много лет действует специальная программа взаимодействия с образовательными организациями. Вы можете видеть сейчас основные ее модули на экране.
For many years we have cooperation program with, from Kempi Russia, and you can see the key points of that program here in this slide.
И здесь выделено цветом, зеленым цветом, те положения, которые претерпели модернизацию в условиях веб-обучения и взаимодействия.
So you see the points that are in green, that means that they have been changed in the situation that we had to face now.
Как вы видите, основные модули были вынуждены трансформировать как раз в условиях, которые сложились.
So as you can see, the key modules were being changed in this situation.
И если взаимодействие в плане сотрудничества в поставках оборудования на особых условиях осталось без изменений,
and if we speak about the equipment supply, it's not changing,
то вот как раз следующие этапы взаимодействия должны были резко трансформироваться.
The next steps of cooperation were to face a rapid change.
В частности, консультации, технологическое сопровождение, пусканалодочные работы нужно каким-то было образом переводить в онлайн-формат, так как посетить учебные центры и сделать это в офлайне было невозможно.
So, for example, giving technical support and consulting through visiting the educational institution became an impossible task.
Практически всю активность по проведению семинаров, консультаций, обучения мы перевели именно в дистанционный формат через проведение вебинаров.
So all the seminars, conferences, masterclasses, roundtable discussions became online.
Особое внимание уделили подготовке к демонстрационному экзамену, который стал уже фактически обязательным в последнее время.
So we paid a specific attention to the preparation for the demonstration exam, which lately became an obligatory option.
Итак, хочу подробно остановиться на том, каким же образом мы построили обучение и взаимодействие с образовательными организациями в веб-формате.
So I would like to pay more attention to the process that we organized for the cooperation with the educational institutions.
Первое, что мы разработали, это серия вебинаров для различных модулей и уровней специалистов.
So first of all, we created a number of webinars for different level specialists.
Здесь вы можете видеть, каким образом мы разделили эти вебинары и как мы их проводили.
Here in this slide you can see how we divided these webinars, and in the picture you can see the way that these webinars were carried out.
Одним из ключевых модулей стали вебинары для руководителей образовательных организаций с целью проинформировать их о тех возможностях, которые мы готовы транслировать в веб-формате.
So the key moments here were the webinars for the heads of the regional education institutions, through which we were giving them the information, what opportunities we are giving.
Это позволило нам фактически со всеми регионами наладить контакт и перейти к следующему этапу вебинаров уже для преподавателей и мастеров производственного обучения.
So these webinars gave us a chance to organize the process of communication and gave us a chance to follow the next step and go to the webinars for teachers and vocational instructors.
И одним из главных ключевых звеньев, естественно, при обучении преподавателей и мастеров производственного обучения стало знакомство с новыми технологиями по сварке.
So the key moment here was also the introduction of the teachers and vocational instructors to new equipment functionality and welding technologies.
И подготовка этих преподавателей к проведению демонстрационного экзамена в качестве уже ответственных лиц.
And also the preparation of these people, we mean teachers and vocational instructors, for the demonstration exam.
особое внимание уделили специальным вебинарам для студентов, которые сдавали демонстрационный экзамен, и для них как раз проводились именно настройки и вебинары по функционалу оборудования.
So we paid much attention to the webinars that were devoted to the for the remote training for the graduates so that they were able to take the demonstration exam.
Еще одним интересным решением стало взаимодействие с Союзом WorldSkills России в плане создания веб-библиотеки специальных учебных роликов.
So one more interesting solution that we found was the cooperation with the WorldSkills Russia on the creation of a web library with different video tutorials.
В настоящий момент собрана большая база таких видеоучебных роликов.
So currently we have a huge library of such video tutorials.
Мы разбили их по категориям, а именно это по каждому типу сварки.
So we divided them into categories. So first of all, it's for different types of welding.
А также по каждому типу оборудования, на котором происходит демоэкзамен и проведение учебного процесса.
And also depending on the type of the welding machine.
Для более оперативного взаимодействия на местах мы подключили к этому расширенную сеть дилеров в разных регионах страны.
For a quicker cooperation, we referred to the dealers in different regions of the country.
Это позволило максимально эффективно работать с каждым образовательным учреждением в конкретном регионе.
So it gave us a chance to work really effectively with each educational institution in different regions.
И в настоящее время, несмотря на изменения в лучшую сторону в некоторых регионах пандемической ситуации, эти видеоролики обучающие очень хорошо используются в учебном процессе.
And currently, despite the fact that the situation with the pandemic in different regions is changing, web library video tutorials are now being used.
Еще одним важным сегментом сотрудничества стала разработка 3D-инструкций.
So one more point in cooperation, which was really important, was a 3D instructor creation.
Который позволяет пошагово настроить оборудование, перелистывая странички этих веб-инструкций.
So these web instructions give a chance to a user to set the equipment just looking through the pages of the instruction.
Если же возникают какие-то вопросы, есть обратная связь, и обучающийся может в прямом эфире задать вопросы, что он должен сделать, каким образом настроить каждый параметр.
We also give some kind of feedback so that if the user faces any problems, he can go to live streaming and to ask all the questions he has.
И 3D-инструкции мы разработали в начале на первом этапе. Только найти тип оборудования, которое применяется на региональных чемпионатах и национальных.
So, first of all, we created these 3D instructions for the types of the equipment which is used for the selection competitions in the regions.
В настоящий момент расширили уже практически на всю линейку оборудования, которое используется в образовательных процессах.
So now we have a widespread variety of the types of equipment with 3D instructions.
Еще одним важным элементом стало то, что с каждым годом сложность и функциональность оборудования увеличивается, и в обычное время мы обучали и демонстрировали новинки всегда на каких-то чемпионатах офлайн.
So one more difficulty is that the equipment usage is becoming more and more difficult, and we were trying to use the offline competitions to give the trainings on how to use the equipment.
А в этом году из-за ситуации с пандемией нам пришлось представлять новинки, которые будут использоваться в будущих чемпионатах, также в веб-формате.
So this year, according to this pandemic situation, we had to show new equipment, all the innovations using an online format.
Представление новых возможностей оборудования мы проводили как при помощи наших инженеров на местах в регионах.
So we were giving the presentation of new equipment with the help of our representatives in the regions.
Так и использовали новую возможность, обращая внимание на следующий слайд.
And we were also using one more new possibility, and I would like you to pay attention to this slide.
В Москве была открыта школа сварки, которая как раз являлась базовой площадкой, на которой записывались учебные видеоролики, и эти учебные видеоролики транслировали именно наши победители по сварке Евро и чемпионата мира в Казани.
So we opened a welding school in Moscow, and on the basis of this welding school, we created a series of different tutorial videos, and those who were participating in these videos were the winners of the EuroSkills and International WorldSkills competition 2019.
Это позволяет нам также и в веб, и в офлайн формате, в зависимости от ситуации, демонстрировать самые новые варианты сварочных технологий, лучшие сварочные аппараты и применять весь наш 70-летний опыт компании для этого процесса.
So this welding school gave us an opportunity to show the latest welding technologies both in online and on offline format, and also to share the 70 years experience of Campi Russia.
И на сегодняшний день мы считаем, что один из вариантов международного сотрудничества также у нас возможен через школу сварки, на которой мы планируем взаимодействовать с другими странами.
And we also think that we can organize a cooperation with different other countries worldwide with the help of this welding school.
К сожалению, пандемия повлияла на наше плотное сотрудничество с некоторыми странами СНГ.
So unfortunately, the pandemic situation influenced our partnership and cooperation with some CIS countries.
И тем не менее, мы открыты к сотрудничеству, и как только будет возможность перейти в режим офлайн, мы будем с удовольствием работать.
But nevertheless, we are happy to have any kind of cooperation, and as soon as it's possible to go to offline again, we are ready to start it.
Ну, а на сегодняшний момент мы готовы поделиться своим опытом, который наработали, начиная с марта месяца, именно по веб сотрудничество с образовательными организациями в разных регионах.
So as for now, we are ready to share our gained experience that started from March of this year, and this experience refers to the web communication with different educational institutions.
Мы открыты к сотрудничеству, мои контакты на экране, и будем рады начать работать с вами.
So we are ready to start the cooperation with you, and you can see the contacts of Sergey here in this slide. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask.
Thank you very much. Спасибо, Алина. Спасибо всем.
Thank you, Sergey. I think that you show us one of really best cases when you have this systematic approach of cooperation with WorldSkills and with the educational system. And that you show us that if we are talking about online, we have to think about all our categories who are involved in educational process. So we have to think about teachers and masters. We have to think about students. We have to identify the way how to train all of them. Thank you that you started the special welding school for training teams and training students. And especially also your idea with simulation and video trainings. So as you can see, I think that the real strengths in Russia that we have a network of education system, a network of partners who really support not just competition, but who support the system. So actually behind the competition is a big system. So this is the interest for our partners to work with us, and it's really great that we have this relationship with you. Thank you. And now I would like to give the word to Sergey from Fabrika Krasak, Paint Factory. He'll share his experience.
Yes, hello colleagues. Алин, прошу включить на Сергея Рыбкина, да, презентацию. Сейчас мы убедимся, что она поставлена. Идет, да? Hello, dear colleagues. I'm a great professional from all over the world. I will tell you about your competence support practice, including in a remote format. My English is not very good, so respected colleagues and international moderator will help me. Итак, my presentation is opening открытые границы, или мы не кочевники, а земледельцы. И хочу я поделиться с вами успешными и не очень практиками, значит, обучение, подготовки достаточно сложной компетенции малярной декоративной работы, где именно все передается от человека к человеку от руки к руке в дистанционном формате и дать понять, как она открывает границы. А также, будучи представителем бизнеса, хочу показать выгоды для бизнеса в реализации непосредственно социальных проектов и поддержки образования и развития компетенции. Ну, вкратце о себе. В отрасли, строительной отрасли финишной отделки я прошел от рабочего производства, бригадира, технолога лакокрасочного производства, маляра, декоратора, поработал прорабом. Переводить мне?
Да. So, speaking about myself a little bit, about my growth in the industry, I used to be a worker, foreman, paint production technologist, also painter, decorator and supervisor.
Yes. Сейчас я являюсь стейкхолдером нескольких бизнесов, в первую очередь по производству лакокрасочной продукции декоративных материалов, а также их нанесению и консалтингу в этом вопросе. И вот также у нас есть образовательная консалтинговая компания в области образования и подготовки кадров. Ну и мы очень много занимаемся социальной деятельностью, организуем социальные проекты, в основном в области стрит-арта, городской среды, поскольку это тоже связано с отраслью малярно-декоративных работ.
So, as for now, as a stakeholder, I have several startup businesses. I'm involved in the production, sales, and decorating. Also, we run the company that offers consulting services and education and training. And also, we are widely involved in the social activities.
Поскольку с самого первого, наверное, дня существования компании мы практически сразу начали заниматься и взаимодействовать с колледжами, проводить мастер-классы, брать ребят на практику, то в 2012 году мы тоже поддержали один из колледжей, который презентовал компетенцию в 2013 году на первом национальном чемпионате России. И уже в 2015 году мы запустили эту компетенцию на национальном финале. И до 2019 года я являлся международным экспертом по 22-й компетенции малярно-декоративной работы.
So for a long time, we have been cooperating with different vocational school and educational institutions. So when we were starting our company, we just supported one vocational school and prepared the competitor for the 2013 national competition. And then we sent him for the international competition. And I started my expert career, and that I was the international expert starting from 2015 till 2019.
И с 16 по 17 годы мне удалось поруководить тренировочным полигоном национальной сборной России по строительному блоку МЦК «Королёв», где более 14 компетенций проводили свои тренировки строительного блока. Сейчас я руковожу специализированным центром компетенций, вот нашим, как раз, Жигулевская долина, Discovery Skills. И поэтому я знаю не только о малярных работах, но и о строительном весь блоке, и понимаю, как сложно и обучать строительному блоку, и оценивать строительному блоку в дистанционном формате.
So in the years 2016-2017-18, I had a chance to be the head of the Specialized Excellence Center, on the basis of which we were training 14 skills. That is why I know all the peculiarities of the building construction sphere, and I know how difficult it is to give online trainings to the competitors and also to give the assessment and do the marking.
Немножко хочу вам показать контекст, почему и как мы взаимодействуем. То есть еще раз, у нас три компании. Производственная компания «Фабрика красок», которая занимается производством материалов и обучением, и нанесением этих материалов непосредственно. Это компания, специализированный центр, это Discovery Skills, который занимается трансляцией компетенций на образование и на отрасли. И это «Анор и состояние», организатор социальных проектов в области городской среды. «Фабрик красок» является золотым партнером в Русскую с России с 2015 года. Ну и вот все вместе мы такая как бы триада, троица, три составляющих: наука, исследования, бизнес-практики и подготовка кадров.
So I would like to speak a little bit more about the previous context. We are the Trinity. We mean three different companies that are involved in the production of decorative coatings, different paints and related materials, finishing works, training, consulting, etc. And all together we have Advanced Vocational Training Center, which gives science and research, business practices, and also gives some kind of skills development.
Mm-hmm. У фабрики красок уже много лет существует партнерская сеть, то есть наши отдельные бизнес-единицы с нами связаны только договором по всей России, а также странам бывшего Советского Союза, странам СНГ. У нас есть три бренда в трех ценовых категориях, полный ассортимент декоративных покрытий и красок, есть комплексное решение в вопросах безопасности среды обитания, которое сейчас актуально в рамках пандемии, и также мы являемся такой именитой и авторитетной компанией с интересной историей. Это компания Fistool.
So, speaking about the factory of paints, we have a variety of partners. We mean a partner network in Russia and also in the CIS countries. These are three separated brands that propose three price segments. And we also propose some comprehensive solution for safe living environment, which is really popular now. And we are also having cooperation with a really important company, Fistool.
Немножко слов о СЦК «Жигулевская долина», узкоспециализированный центр подготовки только лишь по компетенции малярно-декоративной работы, по крайней мере, на сегодняшний момент. У нас есть обучающие программы, коллективные индивидуальные подходы по софт-блоку, то есть мягким навыкам, и хард-блоку. Также мы комплексно подходим к вопросам составления, внедрения контроля программ подготовки участник-эксперт-тренер, поскольку всегда успешная подготовка – это именно такая связка сборных регионов.
So, speaking a little bit more about the Specialized Excellence Center, Жигулевская долина, on the basis of which currently we are giving trainings for the painting and decorating only. And I would like to say that we are trying to improve both soft and hard skills of the competitors, and also to organize well cooperation between the expert, trainer, and competitor, because we know that it's a key solution to the success.
Последние 5 лет, когда мы готовили национальную сборную, развивали компетенцию, проведение тренировок, мастер-классов, индивидуальных, массовых, было для нас скорее даже не каким-то событием, а скорее повседневной жизнью. И помимо этого мы всегда старались запустить дуальные связки между учебными заведениями, учениками и представителями отрасли и бизнеса.
So during the last 5 years, we've run several competitions, and it was not like some kind of special thing for us, because it was some kind of a common life that we experience every day. And we were trying also to organize a dual cooperation. We mean not only the competitor and the educational institution, but also the competitor and some business partners and companies.
Также мы занимаемся научно-исследовательской деятельностью в области методических, методологических подходов, программ, поскольку наблюдали за тем, что чтобы подготовить чемпиона, чтобы подготовить кадр на высоком уровне, необходимо испытывать как бы индивидуальный подход. Здесь есть у нас соответствующие разработки, но о них чуть позже.
So we are also trying to do some kind of scientific research and to organize different educational methodology, because we know that only a individual approach gives high results and gives a chance to prepare qualified professionals. But I will speak about the scientific research a little bit later.
Например, наша система дистанционного обучения в том числе включает один из таких гаджетов. Вот вы можете видеть здесь фотографию, она такая панорамная. Это специальная камера, специальное цифровое решение, которое помимо того, что занимается видеосъемкой, оно еще и оцифровывает действия. То есть потом, помимо видеосъемки, специальная программа выдает, сколько человек прошел, где он находился, с какой скоростью он ходил. Ну, то, что нам часто показывают после футбольного матча.
And we also have a special system for remote training. You can see this picture, which is the first one, some kind of fisheye camera, which is not only doing the recording, but also digitalizes the actions of the person, of the people who are doing something. For example, how many movements did he do, or how many actions he did.
Mm-hmm. Да, совершенно верно. Поскольку, если процитировать слова человека, который сказал лет уже 120 назад, есть такое учение «Научный менеджмент Тейлора», то любой результат можно описать цифрами процесса. То есть, поэтому любой результат связан с цифрами которыми можно описать процесс достижения этого результата.
So if we refer to the words of one person that was said maybe 120 years ago, he said that any process is defined by the digits of the actions that were involved in this process.
Хочу также рассказать еще одно, ну, коротенько о нашем еще одном направлении. Это организация проектов в области облагораживания среды обитания, ну, стрит-арт в широком смысле этого слова. За эти годы более 50 проектов. В том числе у нас был интересный опыт реализации проекта в дистанционном формате, когда художники из трех городов России, а это три пограничных города, это Сочи, середина России, примерно Тольятти и Владивосток, проводили создание в городской среде арт-объектов в цифровом формате на постоянной видеосвязи, коммуницируя с друг с другом, обмениваясь идеями, мнением. И вот такой вот телемост онлайн-создания проектов у нас прошел еще несколько лет назад.
So I would like to tell you briefly about the projects in the field of habitat improvement that we had almost 50 projects realized, and we have one digital experience that was many years ago. It was the simultaneous creation of art objects with the help of experts from Tolyatti, Sochi, Vladivostok, which actually are really far from each other. So it was in a digital format with constant video broadcast, and they were sharing the ideas, experience, etc. So many years ago, we already had experience working in a digital format.
Несколько лет назад я с экспертом из Австралии договорился повторить этот эксперимент. И я думаю, сейчас я стал посвободнее, мы сможем организовать такой вот телемост по созданию одновременно арт-объектов в нескольких странах, так что если будет интересно, тоже подключайтесь к проекту, можно будет в дистанционном цифровом формате совместно творить, оценивать, обучать.
So a few years ago I've discussed the idea of creating the same digital format art object creation with an expert from Australia, and if you are interested in it, for example, you would like to participate, please feel free to contact us, and we would be glad to have you in our team.
Я вам обещал рассказать, зачем же бизнесу это нужно. Все-таки задача бизнеса – это коммерция, коммерциализация. Мы верим, что вот в отрасли финишной отделки, на ней основную часть должны занимать именно краски, декоративные покрытия, поскольку в них очень много добавочной ценности именно человека, да, то есть его мысли, его идей, его навыков, в отличие от ряда других товаров-заменителей. И вот декоративные покрытия – это глина для творца, а руки мастера создают шедевр, живут веками, кормят и дают кровь ему и его себе, и в этом очень много добавочной ценности.
So, as I've already mentioned, I promised to tell you why business is interested in the educational process. And as I've already said, we mean painting and decorating. It highly involves the person, personal experience, and that's why human capital value is added. And it's really important how personality, how ideas and creativity of each person influences this very sphere, we mean painting and decorating.
И мы искренне верим, всегда с этим жили, что наша отрасль – это поле, которое нужно прежде возделать, а уж потом собирать урожай, поэтому мы очень много делаем, как земледельцы, ухаживая за землей. Ну и, безусловно, наша позиция к социальной деятельности – это культура в организации. Почему в том числе нас часто выбирают и наши сотрудники, и наши партнеры в регионах? Потому что они хотят и выбирают культуру и имидж компании. Люди хотят работать там и с теми, где они могут с гордостью говорить, как много их организаций, коллектив. То есть они делают для общего блага.
So we are really sure in one thing, that our sphere, we mean painting and decorating, is a field that is to be cultivated first of all, and only after these many, many years of cultivation we can do the harvest. That is why we are paying so much attention to the development and why we are involved in different social activities. We think that it's important to be socially active, so that all the people understand that the company is not only producing some kind of items, but also is trying to improve the world for the better.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Ну, нет, наверное, я уже рассказал, в принципе, да, что мы открывали компетенцию, что также после того, как мы открыли ее в России, мы с радостью помогли нашим собратской государству, это Казахстану, и тоже помогли им открыть компетенцию у них и несколько лет ее поддерживали.
So as I've already mentioned, we were the pioneers of the skill painting and decorating in Russia, and we also helped our friend country, which is Kazakhstan, to also to start this skill in their country. And for many years we gave much support to them.
Этот год мы начинали с организации очных мероприятий, собрали несколько тренировок, в том числе с чемпионами, чемпионами Европы. Но потом в апреле, как и всех нас, застала пандемия, и нам пришлось буквально за две недели переключиться на формат дистанционный. Мы провели на тот момент две академии. Это повышение квалификации мастеров производственного обучения. Это было очень нелегко, но мы справились.
So at the beginning of this year, we started with some offline trainings with, and in April, with all the situation that all the whole world had to face, we had only 2 weeks to rearrange the process and to start everything in a distant format. So we've managed to run through academies and also some refreshing training for teachers.
Да, и сделав старт в мае в формате дистанционных подготовок, мы уже к сегодняшнему дню провели еще масштабный круглый стол с несколькими странами, организовали тренировку к финалу готов в дистанционном формате, сделали открытый мастер-класс, и вот сейчас непосредственно у нас проходит второй поток Академии повышения квалификации мастеров.
And starting from May, we also... really expanded our opportunities. First of all, we had a roundtable discussion. After that, we had an online training session named Ready for the National Competition. And now we're giving open master classes for industry experts and masters of vocational training.
Безусловно, нам в этом вопросе помогает система дистанционного обучения. К ней завязана вебинарная платформа. Мы с вами находимся в Discovery TV студии, где откуда происходит съемка всевозможными камерами, в том числе панорамными при необходимости. И у нас есть наработанные программы, в том числе по инклюзивному образованию.
So, of course, we are doing that all with the help of the distance learning system, and also we are using webinar platform, and now currently we are in the Discord TV studio, and also we have different other platforms to use.
И в левом углу вы можете наблюдать навигатор, там расписаны все модули, которые относятся к нашей компетенции, и привязаны все к ней наработанные материалы, видеотестов, рабочих тетрадей, мастер-классов, стандартов работ. И вот это является таким у нас навигатором при подборе дистанционной формы подготовки.
So in the left corner you can see the navigator, which we are using. This navigator contains all the modules, all the information, workbooks, presentations, video workshops, and lectures, and we are using all these materials in a distant format.
Так, ну, в этом мы уже тоже поговорили. Хочу сказать о плюсах. Безусловно, без каких-то серьезных преодолений нет осмыслений открывающихся новых возможностей. И работа в дистанционном формате, в том числе в рамках Академии повышения квалификации мастеров и в рамках тренировки к национальному финалу, позволила нам привлекать тьюторов просто из десятка городов России, а также из Киргизии, Германии, Сербии и даже Австрии. Участвовал в тренировке наша чемпионская пара, это Патрик, австриец, который победил на Евроскиллз 2017, и его жена Ольга, это наша российская участница, которая взяла медальон, и они тоже приняли участие в тренировках. Поэтому, безусловно, дистанционный формат позволяет нам значительно расширять границы и убирать их полностью.
So I would like also to speak about the advantages of the distant format. I'm sure that without any challenges, we are not able to achieve any good results. And I would like to share the experience that we had a chance to involve different tutors, mentors from all over Russia and also from all over the world. We were having experience of cooperation with experts from Kyrgyzstan, Germany, Serbia, Austria. We had Patrick, who was the European champion in 2018, and Olga, who got a medallion for excellence. So they were helping us a lot. And да, все.
Они нам очень помогали. Они непосредственно в этот момент отделывали свой дом, вышли с нами на видеосвязь, показали, как клеить обои, как красить. Прямо непосредственно на объекте продемонстрировали нам это.
So Patrick and Olga were painting and decorating their own house. That is why they were using their house as a workshop and were giving trainings from their own home.
Безусловно, мы столкнулись, поскольку мы уже вот к этому моменту, начиная с мая, сделали три мероприятия, вот сейчас заканчивается третье, в дистанционном формате, обучение, конкурсное задание и оценка. Мы столкнулись, безусловно, с множеством проблем. Это разность фотографирования, видеосъемки на местах, сложности с передачей нам этих материалов, с удержанием отраслевых стандартов в процессе оценки.
So as I've already mentioned, we had an experience to run three different events starting from May, and we faced different kinds of problems. So connected with training, also the competition itself and the assessment and marking process. So first of all, it was the problems with shooting conditions, different lighting, also shooting standards that were not absolutely the same, and people were taking photos from different distance. They were horizontal or vertical, all different. And also, все, дальше вы еще не говорили.
Да, и, безусловно, от итерации к итерации, то есть от раза к разу, мы приобретаем опыт, дорабатываем наши системы, и на сегодняшний день у нас есть достаточно качественное решение. Оно состоит из системы оценки экспертами на местах, то есть не дистанционной, а на местах по части модулей, очень детальном дистанционном многоуровневом контроле, двух-трехуровневом системе ответственности и, безусловно, дифференцированном подходе в выборе средств оценки, контроля, исходя из непосредственных аспектов.
So just step by step we were trying to reduce the number of problems we had, and we had a really good solution here. So first of all, we've organized the assessment by experts on site so that they could do the marking at the place. And also we are organizing remote multi-level control.
Как вы видите, в правом углу это наше конкурсное задание. Здесь вы видите обои, покраску двери глянцевыми красками, две фрески, которые являются плоскими, и одну декоративную сложную работу. Поэтому, конечно, было очень много особенностей при оценке этой дистанции.
So in the right corner, you can see the test project that we were giving to the competitors, and you can see that it's rather complicated. We can see that they need to perform different kind of techniques. That is why we had many issues when doing the assessment and marking of this test project.
И, безусловно, вот эти три этапа итерации, наработанный опыт мы передали нашим коллегам, которые уже в понедельник начинают национальный финал России по нашей компетенции.
And also we've shared this experience that we've gained during these three competitions we've run. So we gave this experience to our colleagues who are going to start the competition, the national competition next week.
Отдельным вызовом для нас была как раз вот тренировка перед национальным финалом. Она прошла в августе. Это было 5 участников, 16 дней, по 8 часов. После тренировки была полная имитация 4-дневного чемпионата национального. И, безусловно, когда начинаешь в это втягиваться, то жизнь онлайн становится уже обыденной.
So a big challenge that we experienced was in August. That was a training before the national competition. We had 5 competitors that were supposed to work for 16 days, 8 hours a day and more. And when we faced this situation in an online format and we had to work so much, and we understand that an online format is a common thing for us and it's not a different thing from an offline one.
Mm-hmm. Ну, следующий слайд прям коротенько. Разработана система – это единый жесткий стандарт съемки, освещения, расстояния, времени оценки. Мы разработали целые методички, как человеку фотографировать, сделали образцы, технические задания. И вот на сегодняшний день оценка состоит из, по сути, трех видов. Это оценка на местах, и дальше идет фотооценка, видеооценка и видеооценка вживую онлайн.
So just a few words about the assessment approach. We just created all the necessary instructions, we mean methodological guidelines and instructions for the experts who are going to assess. So this assessment includes three experts. First of all, it's assessment on site, also photo assessment and video assessment. And the third one, which is really important, is live video assessment, which we are doing online.
Mm-hmm. И мы приняли на себя, значит, такие внутренние обязательства, что теперь минимум один день в неделю у нас проходит онлайн, и каждую пятницу мы в прямом эфире на всю Россию, на весь мир транслируем мастер-классы, связанные с нашей компетенцией, и вот уже в эту пятницу тоже будет подобный мастер-класс, и каждый раз мы их устраиваем в открытом формате.
So we've taken one challenge for ourselves. We decided to do one day masterclass every week. And this Friday, we are going to have such a kind of masterclass. And we are giving this live streaming for all the Russian Federation.
И что самое интересное, наработанная система оценки позволяет нам не просто дать какие-то знания, но и люди, которые на местах их повторили, сделали по нашему техническому заданию фотографии, отправили нам их правильным образом подписав, а мы можем их оценить и дать человеку обратную связь, что им еще нужно улучшить.
So speaking about the assessment criteria that we've created for ourselves, it's very good practice because, for example, if someone is watching our masterclass and doing their test project in their own, I don't know, the educational institution or somewhere else, he can finish the test project and after that send this result, his or her results to our training center, and we can assess all the results according to the assessment criteria that we've created.
Ну и последний слайд, подведу итоги. Зачем нам это нужно? Я надеюсь, вы поняли, что это наш образ жизни. Он дает нам культуру в коллективе и партнерах, имидж, бренд, маркетинг, открывает для нас мир и, наоборот, нас открывает миру. Повышение нашей внутренней компетенции, хардовых компетенций по непосредственно и софт-компетенций. И, безусловно, взаимодействие с и страной, и миром, мы получаем доступ к лучшему персоналу.
So just in conclusion, I would like to mention once again why we are doing all of this. It's our lifestyle. So first of all, it brings up a good culture in the team and in the team of different partners. And also it's giving us some kind of image, brand, marketing. It helps us to broaden the horizons, discover the world and people. And also the people and the world is discovering us. And we also increase the company's competence in hard and soft skills. And of course, access the entire partner network for searching for the best stuff.
Так что, если кто-то скажет, что пандемия закрыла границы, я хочу сказать, что она их поистине нам открыла для всех. Теперь мы можем, убрав вот этот когнитивный диссонанс, массово начать взаимодействовать, делать проекты, бизнес, коммуникации, сообщества совершенно без границ и расстояний. Организовывать совместные тренировки, скиллс-кэмпы, чемпионаты, проводить взаимную оценку. Поэтому сейчас мир стал более открыт, чем был до пандемии, как мне кажется. Коллеги, в чате находятся наши ссылки, кому если интересно, можете всю информацию взять там. Спасибо большое.
So just briefly, if someone says that this pandemic situation has shut the borders, I would like to say that it's not true. It really opened the borders, gave us a chance to communicate more and more and to share different practices, experience, to do the assessment online all together and to communicate much more.
Thank you, Sergey.
Thank you.
I think that for the countries and our partners who are here, you can use some information from Sergey's presentation to motivate your local partners to join and support the movement. And if your partners will tell that it's very difficult to support movement during pandemic situation, you can really use even this presentation to motivate your partners. So from WorldSkills Russia side, I would like to thank you that you join this session. Sorry, it takes a little bit more time, but from our side, we really would like to show you different experience, because here the presenters was global industrial partners who support WorldSkills movement globally. So you can know now their position. Also, it was presented a few international companies who are support vocational education development. And also we have presented our local Russian national companies who also support us. So this is a holistic picture, holistic scale of different kind of cooperation with different scale of companies. So hope you will find useful this information useful for you, and you will find a way how to increase cooperation with real sector of economy and company and business in your countries. Thank you that you join us. So we are finished for today. Thank you to all speakers, and thank you to Angelika for your support.
Thank you, everyone. Night.